question I get every fall is, can I prune my peach, apple, pear, plum tree yet? If not, when? It's really not a good idea to prune your fruit trees this time of year for a couple of reasons. Number one, we like to retain as much foliage as we can in those trees and keep it healthy as late as we can in the fall. Late season photosynthesis charges our trees up with carbohydrates that are responsible for a strong bloom and good winter hardiness. Typically, we wait until after the first hard freeze to prune our fruit trees, but the answer really is we want to prune them as late as possible. Prune them right before bloom. Christine Pasco has a question about her Sam Houston peach tree. It's approximately 4 years old and fruited until after late winter 2019 freezes when it had already bloomed. Many yellow leaves dropped off in the summer. Well, the reason for that is Sam Houston is very, very susceptible to a bacterial pathogen called bacterial spot. To control it, we spray in the dormant season with a neutral copper product, and you need to be prepared to spray very small doses of copper during the growing season if wet conditions persist. This is the reason this variety never really gained popularity. In wet years, like early 2019, infections will be so bad it'll defoliate. What happened to this viewer's peaches? Well, the answer is this super stink bug buffet. What to do, if anything? Well, really, they're elusive little suckers. This is the main reason we don't grow organic peaches in this part of the world. Insect pressure will cause these fruit to be completely deformed and lead to other disease problems as well. And what are the growths on Jason Wisser's Texas persimmons? Well, the answer is some type of galling insect. It's either an insect or a mite that lays its eggs on the surface of the leaves. The plant responds by forming the gall to protect the young insects. It's really nothing to be concerned about. They're not considered to be of economic consequence. The biggest problem with these persimmons is they're in too much shade. It looks like they're in an understory. And persimmons, just like all other fruit trees, need full sun exposure. Another question I often get is, how can you tell when pears are ripe? If you want to plant pears this winter, do you need two different varieties? Well, judging pear maturity is somewhat elusive. We typically wait until we see a change in ground color from green to a yellowish color, and then we'll take a pear and we'll cut it to make sure that the seeds are nice and ripe. Pears will ripen after they're harvested, but you need to make sure they're physiologically ripe in order for that ripening to progress. And yes, you typically need two varieties of pear trees for good pollination and fruit set. Not only that, you need two varieties with similar chilling requirements so that they bloom at the same time. In League City, Steve and Chi Bearfield are growing all kinds of fruit trees, including figs, persimmons, and even guava. They also got pears for the first time in 4 years, but they've got an unusual golden one thanks to Chi's holiday ornament that hangs around all year. A new take on a partridge in a pear tree. We'd love to hear from you. Click on Central Texas Gardener to submit your questions, pictures, or videos.